Infertility is usually diagnosed when a couple has been trying to get pregnant for a year. And by trying, I mean not using anything to stop. I don't mean working really hard. Sometimes people will say, well, we've not used any prevention for 5 years, but we've only been trying for the last 6 months. No, no, that's 5 years. That counts. So that's the general definition, is 1 year of trying or 1 year of not using prevention. But there are a couple of exceptions. One of them is if a woman is over 35, then we don't want to wait longer than about 6 months, because there is an effect of age and we want to get going on diagnosing and treating any problem. And the other time I would say don't wait a year is if the woman's cycles are really irregular, she's probably not releasing an egg every month. And so trying for a year is probably not going to get very far. And I would ask that that person come in sooner too. People do think it's always an issue with a woman. Of course, that sort of makes sense because she is the one who gets pregnant. But that's not actually the case all the time. About a third of the time, it's a problem with the male partner. So that's part of the reason to come in and talk, and we outline the different tests that we might do and then go from there. The order of the tests would depend somewhat on the history of the couple. But checking the male partner is usually done pretty early in the process, because it's a pretty simple test. It's not very expensive, it's not painful, and we can get that checked off the list pretty early. Infertility breaks down into generally three areas, and it's really basic. You need sperm, you need eggs, and they have to be able to meet each other. About a third of the time, it'll be a problem with the sperm. And about a third of the time, it'll be a problem with the egg production or the egg quality or the hormones. And about a third of the time, it'll be the fallopian tubes, which is the area in the body where the sperm and the egg have to meet each other. And then there are about 10% of people where we really can't find a reason, and we have treatments for them as well.